A Sage's Journey, The Story of Tangrams. A long, long time ago, in a faraway land, there lived a sage. A sage is a very wise man, and this sage was amongst the wisest. He had the cunning of a fox, the wisdom of an owl, and the memory of an elephant. Because of this, the king asked the sage to perform a most difficult and challenging task. He asked the sage to safely transport a pane of glass to the royal palace. The sage knew that this would be a difficult task. The palace was on the other side of the kingdom, across the hottest of deserts, over the widest of rivers, and on the other side of the tallest of mountains. You may ask, why is a pane of glass so important? Long ago, glass was not common. This pane of glass was special. The glass was perfectly square. It was to be used as a window in the royal palace, the first window in the entire kingdom. The sage knew the importance of both the glass and his journey. He also knew that many perils lie ahead. In order to get to the palace, he knew that he would have to cross the hottest and driest of deserts, sail the widest and turbulent of rivers, and climb the tallest and rockiest of mountains. The sage gladly accepted the challenge. To protect the glass from scratches, the sage wrapped it in the finest and softest silk. To protect it from bumps, the sage wrapped a silk package in the toughest canvas he could find. To protect it from all other rigors of the journey, the sage placed the canvas package in the strongest leather backpack. With his cargo securely wrapped, the sage strapped the pack on his back. He turned and looked at his humble house. He knew that it may be the last time he may ever see it. He turned away and took the first step on his difficult journey. Within a day, the sage approached the largest desert he had ever seen. He looked to his left, and all he saw was desert. He looked to his right, and all he saw was desert. He looked straight ahead, and all he saw was desert. Having the wisdom of a sage, he knew that he could not cross the desert on foot, so he found a camel and continued his journey upon its back. After days of riding, the sage finally crossed the desert. Before long, he came to the widest river he had ever seen. He looked to his left, and all he saw was river. He looked to his right, and all he saw was river. He looked straight ahead, and all he saw was river. Having the wisdom of a sage, he knew that he couldn't cross the river on the back of a camel, so he built a boat, jumped aboard, and set sail across the river. After days of sailing, the sage finally crossed the river. Before long, he came to the largest mountain he had ever seen. He looked to his left, and all he saw was mountain. He looked to his right, and all he saw was mountain. He looked straight ahead, and all he saw was mountain. The sage knew that he could not go around or under the mountain. He knew there was only one other way. He began to climb. For days and days, the sage climbed and climbed. After many days of climbing, the sage stood exhausted on top of the mountain. In the valley below, on the other side of the mountain, the sage saw his final destination, the royal palace. Finally, thought the sage, my journey is nearly complete. As he thought, the sage took his mind off the slope before him. He accidentally tripped on a rock. Instantly, the sage was falling down the mountain, head over heels and heels over head. After falling for what seemed forever, the sage finally stopped. Horrified, he took off his pack to inspect the precious commodity. He first removed the canvas package. He carefully unfolded the canvas. He next removed the silk package. He carefully unwrapped the silk. To his amazement, the glass had not shattered into a million tiny pieces. Instead, it broke into only 7 pieces. 2 large triangles, a medium triangle, 2 small triangles, a parallelogram, and a square. The sage couldn't believe his eyes. He tried to arrange the pieces of glass to form the original square. First, he made a rectangle. He then made a triangle. And then a parallelogram. And finally, a trapezoid. After many attempts, the sage finally arranged the 7 pieces in the shape of a square. He carefully wrapped the pieces of glass in the silk to protect them from scratches. He wrapped the silk package in the canvas. He placed the canvas package in his leather backpack. The sage continued on his journey. Later that day, the sage arrived at the palace and presented the package to the king. The king eagerly opened the package. He was shocked to see the broken glass. He demanded an explanation. The sage quickly took the pieces. He arranged them over and over. He showed the king how he had ridden a camel, sailed a boat, and climbed over a mountain on his trek. He told the king how he had accidentally fallen down the mountain and broke the pane of glass. The emperor was quite impressed with the sage's story, but he still wanted a window. "Alas," explained the sage, "all is not lost. With these 7 pieces and an imagination, you can make any figure you desire, be it a camel, a boat, or even a window." By this time, the king was far too busy arranging the pieces to listen to the sage. Within a few days, the king decreed this new game to be the royal game of the kingdom, and Tangrams was born.